suppression of the use of marijuana and of the forces lurking behind it are the most important jobs this department is now engaged in.
In 1930, the records on marijuana in the Washington office of the Narcotics Division scarcely filled a small folder like this. Today, they fill cabinets.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Coloradians, and everyone that's smart enough to listen from the outside.
One of the most amazing plants we've ever discovered.
The pot party, the trippers, the grasshoppers, the hip ones, all gathered in secrecy and flying high as a kite.
Weedies! I got weedy pots!
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to another episode of Stoned Appetit. With your host, as always, it's me, Kip. To my left, I got CB. How are you, CB?
Oh, man, we're catching our stride again, getting back to things. You were out of town this past weekend.
Yeah, we're back in the saddle. And while you had a pretty busy one as well, we kind of teased it a little bit on last week's episode with that little intro. But at the same time, we had a little fun. We had a little fun this weekend, and we're going to have a little fun this week. You know, it's a loaded schedule of pretty much things on the docket for this week and weekend, but we're going to recap everything that happened in Denver. Let everyone know we're not going to talk in detail about the Broncos, but our predictions of 8 or 9 wins looks about on par, so at least we're looking semi-geniuses this morning, and my hangover is finally kicked, so that's kind of nice. After a couple days of partying, it has finally died down. But before we want to get this show on the road, we want to give a quick shout out to our sponsors. As always, we love the two brands. One, Seed and Smith Cannabis Company and Dispensary. They have two locations of their own dispensary, one out on Oakland Street in Commerce City kind of area, as well as their new location, 1413 Heckla Way up in Louisville. Chris, sorry, I was looking at messages on my computer. When I was in Oregon, I had the dart on me because I travel with mine everywhere.
Of course.
It was the fucking fan favorite. I mean, people were like, dude, where do you get this pen? And they're envious because while only Seed and Smith you can get here in Colorado. So, I mean, I had kind of the golden ticket in my pocket. I felt like Charlie's grandfather. I just got up and started walking. I was so jazzed. But the dart pen was the fan favorite.
You know, on that dart pen, one thing I've also realized is I lose that a lot less than other pens. I'm not sure why, but I think it's maybe the shape, but it seems to fit in the pocket a little better.
Shout out to our boy Alden. He kind of said something similar where he thought it was maybe the weight where it wouldn't just necessarily get masked in a pair of pants when you were throwing them like in the laundry so they're not disposed of. Or if you're in the backseat of an Uber, you may feel that pen kind of fall out so you'd be able to kind of find it quicker.
Yeah.
But at the same time, we've talked about how it strokes. Now we're talking about how its sleek design is keeping it from falling. We're avid salesmen and believers in this pen, so that's righteous cause. Check them out. You can grab their products across the fucking city. Go to their website, seedandsmith.com, or go to their Instagram, @seedandsmith, and you can find their links that way, and they have a map where you can buy all their dope. Or you can shoot us a text message or DM. We're usually fairly available, and we'll help you put you on our favorite weed and our favorite dispensaries. And speaking of our favorite dispensaries, Chris, you know, if I'm going to travel at all, I'm going to always carry some edibles with me. And so I stocked up, per usual, on some Eddies before going up to Oregon. Ripples, wild. Those are the hollers. I like the taste buds, too. Those are probably my three right now in that rank. And then I want to see more of the Ebb because I like the pink lemonade, but I like the taste buds as the three spot. I love those little powders that are dissolvables. They're so fantastic. And the best part is you can get all of those things at one of our favorite dispensaries at Cali's Cannabis in Larimer Street. 31st and Larimer was one of their three locations. I call it the most popular one because it's right in the heart of downtown. They've got everything for you. They have a fantastic rewards program. You get $1 for every dollar you spend, and they give you sometimes they just do twofers. Like whenever they're feeling froggy, they're like two for Mondays. And so they're always kind of doing things to kind of reward their customers and their neighborhood folk, as well as those in the industry world. And then, you know, we always have dollar joint cards in our pockets at any given time. But they have two other locations, so check them out, Northfield as well as 8th and Canosa Court. All right, Chris, that was a long ad read, but it was more of a testimonial. So they got that out of us today. I'll give it to him, right? All right, so on the schedule today, for y'all listening in, this is what we've got. We've got weekend recap. We're going to talk food and recap in Portland. I have a bread debate I want to throw at you because I feel like it's a regional thing, but we'll talk about it. There's some news that kind of rocked the Denver food scene. We'll talk about that as well. And then we have a kind of a gauntlet of fun shit going on. Obviously, as we're recording this, the Lumineers are coming through town this week, as well as I saw Circles Around the Sun was on the list for bands that are playing in the state this weekend. So that's another Righteous concert and band, if you can catch them. And then we have a huge episode on Thursday that's going to drop on Friday with our friends from Denver Beer Co. So that's going to be a righteous, righteous trip.
Yeah, I'm excited to check out that new location.
Yeah, and you know how we kind of kept talking about how we're going to use different ways to use the platform to spread the good word about local businesses? We're going to do that with Denver Beer Co. We're going to do a little video caption contest, maybe dabble in the YouTube and the fucking TikTok world. It's going to be fun. And then our high five of the night are restaurants or locations that you miss that have gone. Now, it doesn't have to be based off of COVID. It could have just... they're no longer with us, and they were great restaurants, or they hit the spot. All of those are viable answers, and we'll do those at the end of the episode. So, Chris, let's dive into the first part. You're technically an athlete now.
I've always been an athlete.
Yeah, but like your dad wasn't proud of you, athlete. You were just kind of like one of those subpar athletes.
Right, but I mean, telling him that I got a medal for finishing a race doesn't really entice him to be like, oh, I'm proud of you.
No, he doesn't love you more because of this, but I got to tip my cap. Way to go.
Hey, I finished it, and I woke up at like Saturday morning at like 5:30 to get on the road and get up there in time for it.
So tell our listeners, for those that maybe didn't catch it last week, what the fuck we're talking about?
Yeah, anyways, I guess, you know, throughout the summer, you know, the mountain resort towns, they have various events and stuff, and I guess this was maybe Copper Mountain's big, like, last weekend blowout. They had concerts. They had all kinds of activities going on. But I don't know. I just got the wild hair and signed up for a 7K trail run up Union Peak. It was a beast. Like, the first 2 miles was, like, 900 feet elevation gain, so you're basically just running uphill. And that was a little bit harder than I thought it would be.
All right, so I have a lot to unpack there. So you're telling me there's a weekend-long festivities. You drive up early in the morning, and all you're there for is the fucking trail run? You're not going to stay for the concerts or the cocktails?
Well,
you get a free Mickey when you got down?
No, I wish. I got, like, a free swag bag and a medal. But... like, I think some of their different events they had going on, this was obviously free, but some of those other ones you had to buy tickets to and all that kind of good
ahead.
Stuff. But the silver lining of my trip up there is I stopped by Outer Range on my way home.
Ooh, that is nice. That is very nice.
I mean, some of the best beer in Colorado, hands down. And it's one of the best spots, like, if you're driving back from a mountain or something, just to stop by. They've got tons of room, great outdoor space, and delicious beers.
I don't hate it. I don't hate it, Chris. That's not a bad weekend. You know, the mountains were popping across the board. Last weekend, the Snowmass had Jimmy fucking Buffett, or the weekend before, they had Jimmy fucking Buffett. And then this weekend was Aspen Food and Wine. And obviously, we recorded before we had the lucky opportunity to toot our own goddamn horn, but someone did an expose on us, High Country Time Living, you know, talking food, wine, and weed with Colorado's highest podcast hosts. So shout out to our friend Katie Shapiro from the Aspen Times for the kind words and taking the time to goof off with us. But yeah, it seems like it's been a party. Everyone's kind of getting geared up. It's leaf changing season, and that's going to lead me to my next question. Give me your fuck, marry, kill, or give me just a power ranking. Give me your, you know, three podium people of places or folks don't know about to get some leaf peeping. You know where to change the leaves? Where can I go and see it without getting stuck on 70 or being bumper to bumper?
Damn, I mean...
that's a good question, I mean. It just came to me. It wasn't on the rundown.
Yeah, no. I see you shooting from the hip there.
Yeah, and that's what kind of makes us pros here, Chris. That and the fact that I'm putting my microphone down to eat my circus cookies after I ask questions.
Delicious. Shit, you know, I mean, it's hard to find spots these days where there isn't going to be just incredible amount of traffic, especially when it comes to leaf peeping. You know, if you want to stay off of I-70, if you head towards Buena Vista, like, there's that big stretch around, like, Fairplay in that area. You know what I'm talking about? What road is that? Is that
285?
285. Yeah.
285 is a nice little drive for those. Okay, so it's a little bit weirder. So because of the weather this year, Chris, the leaves are turning a little earlier. So usually we do tail end of September, early part of October. Obviously, we're kind of middle September, and the leaves already look gnarly. I'm seeing people's Instagrams, the girls with the puffy sweaters, they're kicking our ass in likes because the leaves are changing. And our lazy
pumpkin spice fucking lattes.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not a pumpkin spice guy. We turned down the Dunkin' Donuts advertisement because I was like, yeah, that's not us. And no. They're like, it's okay. Thanks, though. But yeah, I think 285 in Buena Vista, the warmer weather and the drier climate is causing it to are causing them to change earlier in the north than they are in the south. Okay, there we go. I got it right. So Steamboat area first, maybe, and then the Buena Vista area a little later, or maybe I have them backwards, but double check the
I'm not sure. Usually
now it's causing me to
usually if you Google like leaf peeping or whatever in Colorado, they usually have kind of like this time scale of when they expect like the different regions to start changing.
Okay, so I was right. Never mind. Because it's getting colder in the northern country, it's already started
right
up towards like Craig and Steamboat.
Yeah.
So I was fucking right. Way to go, Kip. Yeah. So 285 is not a bad one. We're going to be trekking down I-25 deep south here in a minute. Do a little content, but that 285 trek's a really pretty view.
Yeah, that one is good, and you can get out. There's a big area where lots of cars will park and stuff. I mean, it does get fairly busy there, but I mean, there's just patches of really pretty aspen trees out there.
Yeah, and you can always go find dispersed camping if you go up. Oh, yeah. I guess I talked about the Georgetown-Guanella Pass.
Yeah.
I bet that bitch will be popping in like 2 to 3 weeks. It'll be nice. It looks like that's in the central area for September 25th to October 6th. So that's nice. Yeah. We're getting into that season. I fucking love it. Football, leaves changing, grill sesh, which reminds me. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not doing a food ad read today.
No.
We're good. We're good on that one. All right. So that's a great point. 285 Buena Vista for those that are asking. You got a restaurant rec for anybody down there? I know there's a badass ice cream parlor.
Ooh.
I'm trying to think of the place that's really good down there from, is it on that main drag or is it in the, I can't remember.
I don't know. I haven't been down there this summer, so.
I was down there in February, but everything was like partially closed due to the COVID thing. So I'm trying to think of what street that was on. Like, oh, well. All right. So let's keep going on.
Yeah.
So nice weekend in the mountains here in Colorado. And the weeks going before.
Let's hear about Portland, because I've never been, and I hear the food scene's great, obviously, and things like that. So I want to get your experience.
Yeah, so we were only in Portland for a hot minute. So I was actually disconnected from the internet in Central Oregon, just outside of Bend. We were on this resort, it was like an adult camp. There was cabins for folks, and then there was rooms and lodges and such of that. But we had them all. All the guests for the wedding had rented them all. So it was pretty much like we should have played Capture the Flag. I was adamant that we should have played fucking Capture the Flag. Just, you know, two sides of the camp, maybe have some, I don't know. I was disappointed we didn't, but we did dive headfirst into some fun. So it's really set up on this huge S lake, and they let you rent like paddle boards, kayaks, and all that jazz. But there's also like about a 3.5 mile loop. You can just kind of walk and trek around it. A wilderness, walk. Similar to what you did, I did the same fucking thing, but I'm not bragging about it. It was a casual 5K. So I did that Saturday morning. But the Portland food scene is fucking awesome. But this one thing that I have a question about, and I don't know if maybe somebody else can answer this, but I noticed every restaurant we went to, both downtown in northwest Portland, and even on the last trip there, focaccia bread is like the 1A. That is the bread. Everything is on the focaccia. Like, if you, like, you know, when we order, let's say, burrata, what do you get when you get your burrata here in Denver? You usually get some grilled ciabatta or something like that, correct?
I mean, I think it really depends on the style of restaurant.
But these were not even, like, all Italians. These were, like, different styled restaurants. All of them had a focaccia bread of some sort or a sandwich. All of them were on focaccia. That's very interesting.
That's odd. I mean, I love focaccia.
Oh, yeah. I didn't hate it. I ate two fucking loaves of it. Shout out to Please Louise Portland. That's a delicious pizza restaurant up in the north side that was just nestled in there. Had a great time. Nice bottle of wine. It was delicious.
But I feel like